So on behalf of myself and the board of directors of the Republican Club here at Heritage Ranch, we wish you all a Merry Christmas. Tonight is our Christmas program. It's much different than all of our other programs. Tonight we simply celebrate the blessed Christmas season. And so we will not be doing anything else other than Christmas. So I hope you enjoy that lesson. Now, throughout the year, we've had our typical programs where we brought special guest speakers to you. Back in January, we had Colonel Alan West present. In February, of course, we were shut down because we all remember the weather in February. But we still did a Zoom meeting to keep the spirit alive. And then from March through the end of November, we had some great speakers that you all wanted to hear from. We had the governor. Governor Abbott was here. We had the attorney general. Ken Paxton was here. We had state representative Angela Paxton. We had Candy Noble, who was here and is here again tonight. So at any rate, we worked hard to make certain that we brought you the speakers that you've asked to hear from. By the way, I think I said Candy Noble is the representative, right? I did say that, okay. All right, you never know about me. So we are interested in doing the things that you want us to do. For example, our dinner tonight, we use assigned seating. We used to have just open seating, and in talking to all of our members, it was clear that you have certain people you'd like to sit with at the dinner table, and so now we go through assigned seating so that that happens, as long as the table doesn't fill up. Also at the table, we always put either one of our board members or an elected official or a candidate running for office. So you should make friends with those people and ask them all the questions you want to answer. Another thing that we've done this year is we used to always have one entree, and you ask for two entrees. Because some people didn't like fish, and some people didn't like chicken, and some people... So now you get your pick of two entrees. So I'm trying to... That was pretty popular. Okay. So that's good news. And then as we move along this whole program piece, we have upgraded our whole presentation considerably. So now... in a few minutes, you'll hear about our new website that is getting ready to be launched tomorrow morning. But that was all done because our club has grown to a point where for us to bring you the releases that you see, all the communication that comes from our communication folks, and all the what we call bugle blasts that come out, our reservation system, all of that had to be upgraded because our membership is growing so large. So that's being done right now as we speak. So our legislative team has been busy this year. You know about the trip that they made to Austin during the summer to help get key legislative pieces through and to voice our concerns. So that occurred this summer, and then we followed that up with a lot of support, a lot of participation in the election integrity piece. That was all done. So what did all of this result in? Well, it resulted in, this year, a 40% increase in our membership. The largest ever. I like to think that you have shown us that you like all the things that we're doing, that you know that we're listening to you, and that you are responding to that. The other thing is that we're getting an awful lot of encouragement from the current administration, because all the things that they're doing is driving us all to be stronger and better together. Finally, I just want to talk about the last thing that you asked us to do, and you wanted to see more of a patriotic influence in our meetings. So we think we've done that. So let us know if you're feeling a strong sense of patriotism, because that's what good Republicans do. Now, just a quick little story, a true story. But we had the food drive. The marketing team worked on the food drive, and we completely filled up the food pantry for the Ministerial Alliance, which is behind St. Jude Parish. That's where the building is. We filled that up completely during the early part of November. And then, just before Thanksgiving, they took all that food, put it into food baskets, and we delivered it to 80 needy families that would not have had Thanksgiving. It's kind of a funny thing, if I could just share this moment with you. So I worked on the food drive under Dale Barnes, and then my church asked us to participate in delivering these 80 food baskets. So I thought to myself, you know, one day I'm here as a good Republican working on providing food for the food pantry. The next day, the next week, I'm at the church helping to deliver 80 food baskets to needy families. And I thought for a moment, and I just want to share this thought with you, you have to be a Republican to be a good Christian. I don't see how that works any other way. You have to have the desire to help, which is what we have as good Republicans. And then you have to have the good Christian faith and Christian attitude, which we all have. That's why we are Republicans. So the thought occurred to me that I needed to relate to you that little sense that I felt. Finally, I want to say that in a few minutes, in a few minutes, you're going to see a little bit of the new website that is coming up tomorrow. You're going to, during dinner, you're going to see clips of old Christmas movies that were played with light music behind so that it doesn't interrupt your dinner. But look, I went through and saw this video, and I saw all these Christmas movies and the characters that are in these movies, and I remembered when I was a small boy, that's what Christmas was like. That's what Christmas was like. It was simple, and it was innocent. And that we have trouble with today, don't we? But anyway, I think you'll enjoy that. As I had to do my COVID check with the office at 3:30 this afternoon with the doctor's office, and you know, you have to do the procedure, then you got to wait about 30 minutes for the results, which I am negative. But at any rate, the point that I want to make is, I sat and thought for that 30 minutes about these old Christmas videos. So if you have a mind to do so, take a look up at the screen during the dinner time, and you'll see some interesting things. Bob worked very hard to put that collage together for us, and thank you, Bob. Okay. At this time, Bob's going to give us a little preview as to what the new website's going to look like. We've worked, the marketing team has worked very, very hard on this. I hope you enjoy it. Okay. Yes. I thank you. After all this rehearsal, I forgot to tell you that under your napkin, Under the napkin at each table, there's one little sticker under one of the napkins. So our volunteers worked very, very hard on these table settings. So you get to keep them. If you have the sticker, then you get to keep the table setting, okay? And if for some reason, you don't want that table setting, please give it to somebody else at the table that got us. One last thing. Please add a little water to the center, because it'll need some water by the time you go home. Okay? Thank you. Bob?
I want to introduce you to the new website, but I want to introduce you to the evolution that we went through. To begin with, we had 20 members back in 2009, and with the 20 members, we were able to keep track of everything and the membership on a piece of paper. We went to 100 members and got a little hairy. And we had to go up to a spreadsheet. Then, 2017, we had 200 members. And when we did that, we had to get a database. After that, we went up to 350 members and had to go to a website to keep track of everything. Finally, we're at 600 members. It's totally out of hand. We have a website. We have 20 or 30 spreadsheets. We're having trouble keeping up with that. So today we introduced a new Christmas present for everybody, including us. We're introducing a new website for the Republican Party. The website not only has a database, it has membership tracking, it has financial information. We take credit cards now, which is great. Get away with it, Eventbrite. We have email processing in it. Everything you need in a membership management system. Tomorrow, the next day, you will receive an email that gives you your temporary or your new name to log in and a new password. The email will show you how to log in. You take the link to the database. You log in with that. You can change the name and the password, whatever you want. And then your operation. Get to the website. Here is the website. Starts off with a welcome message, scrolls down to the purpose of the Republican Club and Heritage Ranch. You then have a list of the upcoming events. You click on these events and it takes you to a registration so that you can sign up right there. Then we have a list of recent articles that we kind of keep track with information about what's going on. Then there's a list of the presentation of the current most recent event. You can click on that and it takes you to it. Then we have a list, a rolling list of pictures of other events that have occurred. Oh, and then we have the weather, just in case. Okay, go back up to the menu. If you're not a member, you can click here to join. It takes you to a page where you can select what membership you want. And it also gives you all the information you need to fill out to become a member. And then it charges you, and you can use your credit card to pay for it. Or you can go up here to the corner and click in, log in as a member. And then you put in your name and password. Should have been this early. You can go to the About page tells you who we are, why you become a member, and it gives you some history of the club. What's nice about this is it tells you our mission and who we are and why we're here. And then you can click here and join, actually. And then you go to the event calendar, which tells you what events are coming up. Here's a view of all the upcoming events that we have. From there, you can go directly to the event and sign up for it. You can register and pay for it there. You go to photo albums. It gives you pictures of all the events that we've had so far. To walk you through these. Then we have government information. You have the election information. And then you have information for members only. I would like for you to log on to this thing and just play with it. Look at all the information we have. I can show you tonight, but it's kind of boring. So, and this is our website. Enjoy.
Thank you, Bob. Now we have Ben Brown with the invocation for dinner.
Thank you, Jack. I had several people ask me, are you going to pray for the folks in Kentucky and Arkansas and Illinois? The answer is yes. As we enter this happy time of the year, we need to remember our friends. We have some people from Heritage Ranch who have relatives real close to the Kentucky, and it's devastation up there, so we need to remember them in our prayers. But it is a time of celebration, and we need to remember that as well. And I can imagine the first Christmas ever. It was a non-event, except to a very small group of people. The shepherds, Mary and Joseph, the innkeeper probably knew about him. But suddenly, in the heavenly hosts, angels proclaimed. So let's pray. Father, we do come to you tonight with mixed hearts. Hearts of gratitude, hearts of thankfulness, but hearts of sorrow and concern. We ask that you come as the Prince of Peace. Give us peace in our heart. We pray for the leaders in Arkansas and Kentucky and Illinois and those states that are devastated. Give them courage, comfort, energy, and wisdom as they face the trials of their citizens and their fellow neighbors. We thank you for those that are lending helping hands. We pray for their safety and all those folks that will be coming. And Lord, for those who lost loved ones, we pray for their comfort and their peace at this time. Now give us a happy celebration tonight, Lord, because of the coming of the Christ child and what that means, that you cared for us. In Christ's name we pray.
I'd like to introduce to you Dr. John Huffer from our civil planning organization. So, he's going to introduce the woman from Georgia.
Thank you very much. I thought Jones to come up here first, but I guess you guys give me, I tell you what, I am so excited about tonight. I stand next to Charlie. I bet you figure out who he is when he walks in here. This group is called Clutch, and they are ranked 11th in the world. 11th in the world. And they consist of Marcus, I want to make sure, Scott, and Charlie, and then Steven. And they are awesome. Oh, wait, please jump in. Oh, guess what? They're not going to be here for a couple more minutes, so you get to hear me. I don't know where the heck was going to be. Well, let me tell you something. I was sitting at the table here, and they asked me why did I want to join that public service. And I told them a few years ago, I walked into one of the restaurants here over at the Fairview Town Center, and I walked in, and the service says, come right this way. Come here and sit right over here. I go, wow, what's going on here? I said, thank you very much. He says, oh, that's fine, Mayor Culberson. So I thought, yeah.
Sure. Actually, John stole my thunder. No. I just wanted to say, put in a pitch for the vocal majority, because I'm not a member of the vocal majority, of course, and John is. But some of you may have gone to the show that was in the Eisman for 4 performances, Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday, 2 performances. And I saw today that they will also be singing with the Plano Symphony Orchestra at, I know, St. What's the church out there?
Well, you can go to the Plano Symphony Orchestra's website and you get all the details on that.
Yes. And also in Frisco.
Yes, in Frisco as well.
And if you're interested in Christmas music or any music at all, they are marvelous. And we're very lucky to have a few of them here tonight as a quartet, which is special. But as a group, they're over 100. I think there were 110 on stage at the Eisman. So I'm putting in a big plug for them as an onlooker, just an appreciation of music.
Thank you very much. So, are we ready now? And without further ado, the ranked 11th in the world, Clutch. Oh, there they are.
Just Obviously, the last 18 months, our opportunities to sing live music has been limited, to say the least. And so I know we've performed here before for some of you, but for those of you who don't know us, we just wanted to go ahead and introduce ourselves real quick, so we'll do that now. We are very excited to be here again. So to actually introduce ourselves, my name is Steven. I sing the baritone part. To my left here, we've got Marcus, and he sings bass. That's the shortest, Asianist one who sings bass. And we've got Scott here, Scott Hale singing lead. And then on the end, we've got Charlie Lotspeech singing tenor. For our next few songs, we wanted to sing a few, in the holiday spirit, sing a few Christmas tunes for you, and then we'll get back to some of our more traditional barbershop songs. But yeah, we just wanted to share some holiday tunes since it is, that time of the year. So please enjoy.
You have
Mary had a baby.
Oh. thanks for having us this evening. Stephen was saying it's been a while since we've had a gig in front of anyone. In fact, it's really strange because the last time we had a gig was in this room. For John Hubbard's election party or whatever it was, that was our last gig. So we were like, when I came to check out the sound system, I walked in the room and I was like, I have been here before. And I realized, oh yeah, that's exactly where we sang before. And we were hoping to get to go to contest right before all that COVID stuff happened. And as John said, we're ranked number 11th place in the world. We actually came in 11th place. Oh, thank you. We came in 11th place twice in a row. So doesn't mean anything unless you do it three times. I mean, two times. Oh God. So we've been hoping to get back to contest, and we're hoping that we get to go this next summer, which will be in Charlotte, North Carolina, in 2022. And so, if you're not familiar with the Barbershop Harmony Society, they do a contest where you have to qualify for contests in the early spring, and then the quartets that do qualify compete in three rounds. They do the quarterfinals, and they have about 54 quartets from all over the world who have made it to that round, and they whittle it down to the top 20 for the next round, and then they go to the top 10. So we've been on the very outside of it both times. But thankfully, when you are the 11th place quartet or the 21st, you get to do mic testing. And so we got to open up the finals night two times, but we haven't gotten to be on the finals night. So we're not bitter. But we'd like to sing two contest songs for you. They're a little bit different than the rest of our music. The first song is from a musical called Alice in Wonderland. It's kind of a strange one. It's all about the Mad Hatter and what he does for a living. It's a little different than just drinking tea, like in the regular books. And then we'll close with a song called It's Today. So thank you for being such a wonderful audience and inviting us out here. We've enjoyed getting to make music more than you could possibly know. So this has been a real treat for us. But enjoy.
That was wonderful. Listen, what we don't understand is, how could you just be number 11? Who could be the other 10? I don't.
You should be the judge.
We are. This is the judge. Did you hear that applause? All right, listen. We are definitely going to have you back because our people love you. But the next time you come back, I mean, we noticed the blue jackets, and we're Republicans. You see my tie. So hopefully you will come back. Wait. When you come back, and you will be invited back, thanks to our good friend, Dr. Hubbard, he wants to take over before I embarrass us any further.
No, I was just going to say, I'm going to be running again for town council, so you guys can come back for my kickoff campaign.
Dr. John, you got a couple hundred votes right here, okay? All right. Thank you very much. You were wonderful, and you are number one in our book. Okay, I'm going to ask Clayton Barnes now. We have our next guest to present. So, Clayton, come on up.
It's a time to be jolly, and as a special treat tonight, we have a visitor who's going to come and visit you. And if we would, I hear something in the back. Is that who I think it is? There's an elf. Where's Santa? Santa's here. Comes Santa Claus. Hey! Here comes Santa Claus!
Hey! Oh, you people are beautiful! Beautiful! We've got the elves, the jingle bell kids! Oh,
got a gift for everyone, and he's got his elves with him. Christmas. The number is 295-140. Here we go. Here it is. Okay, he's going to draw another one. Here's another one. And this is a meal at the Darden Restaurants. It's a $25 gift card. Number is 295-308. There in the back, another Santa Claus. That's a fake Santa Claus back there. Okay. Through the benefit of Al Molino, I think you have known this from last time, we have 4 pair of men's or women's shoes, specialty footwear, international shoes. Very comfortable. There's a catalog here, and what we're going to do, we're going to have 4. You can have a man or a woman. And we thank Al for these 4 pairs of shoes. So the first one 295-269. Here we go. There you go. It can be a man's or a woman's. The second pair is going to be number 295-246. 246. 246. Sorry about that, Santa. We'll get another one. Here's the winner. The next one is 295-259. 295-259. They went home. Okay, Santa, we're getting there. The next one is 295-157. Pat. Okay, the next number is 295-261. 261. Bill.
Not here.
The next one. Also a very nice photo. It's a ink and pencil drawing, and it's "We Must Never Forget This Country Does Not Belong to Them. It Belongs to You, the American People. This is your home, this is your heritage, and our magnificent American liberty is yours, God-given right." Donald Trump, and this was June 26, 2021. This is a 21 of a series of 100. And also, this was donated by Al Milano. So let's give Al a hand. Time to say thank you to Helga and her team for the decorations and what she has done. It's a beautiful spirit, and I think she stands. Stand up, Helga. Stand up, Helga. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
to come to the final part of our Christmas dinner, and this is something we need some participation from all of you. Do we have the next slide, Bob? Before we do have the participation, you're going to see a few things happen. We're going to dim the lights and light the candles. We'll also have, eventually, we'll have our lovely pianist come up and play the piano for us while we, you, all sing. But before we do, we're sort of featuring one, I would say one of the most common or popular Christmas carols throughout the world. And if you look behind me, the story behind the song of Silent Night. This is a memorial that was built in the site where Silent Night was first, I should say, put together, you'll hear why I say that, and performed. And I want to give you a little bit, just a brief history about it, because it's very significant. Go back to 1818, long time ago, in Oberndorf, in Austria. And this is in the Tyrol area of Austria, wonderful for skiing. It's between Salzburg and Innsbruck, which is famous for skiing. And it was 1818 in the small church of St. Nicholas, not this. This was built later on because the original church had some issues through a flood. It was destroyed and a new church was built, but so was this monument because of this Christmas carol that we'll all be singing in a little while. The pastor, the assistant pastor, was a gentleman by the name of Josef Mohr, and his organist was Franz Gruber, who has become famous because he owns the Christmas carol. Anyway, at that time, the organ, a couple of days before Christmas, the organ didn't play anymore. It was broken, and they didn't know what was wrong. A lot of stories circulated. Some said it was the varmints, the mice. Other people said it was rust, and other people said it was the weather. They couldn't get it fixed in time. At the same time, in 1818, there was a group of actors that came around to the villages in the Austrian Alps, and they were giving the performance about the birth of Christ based on St. Luke and St. Matthew. And the pastor, who was Josef Mohr, he went to the performance, and on his way home, he was walking through this beautiful countryside, which you see here, plenty of snow, beautiful clear sky, and he was worried about not being able to produce music in his church for Christmas Eve. And he remembered, as he looked out into this beautiful landscape, that he one day, some time ago, wrote a poem called Silent Night, but it had no music. So he came back to his church and he got in touch with his organist, Franz Gruber, and he asked him to please come up with some music that he could play on his guitar, since they couldn't get the organ fixed, and it would suffice for the music for midnight, for their church, their midnight mass and other services. And Franz Gruber produced what we know as Silent Night. And together, Josef Mohr and Franz Gruber sang, and then the whole congregation sang. Now, shortly after that, a repair person came along and repaired the organ. And as a trial to make sure the organ was fixed, Franz Gruber played Silent Night. And the organ repair person was so impressed, he went back to his place in Austria, and he began to spread the word of this beautiful song. there were two groups of people that were very instrumental in spreading the word. One was the Raiders. They came to the United States. Silent Night was first played in a church, New York Trinity Church, in New York City, and that was in 1863. And then the other group went to Northern Europe, and even the King of Prussia said that every church had to play this song. Now it is translated in 300 languages all around the world, what we know as Silent Night. So this is the first song that we're going to sing. But I might add, I was happy to tell this story because I have been to Oberndorf for 7 years. When years ago in the 1970s, my husband, my son, and I skied there every winter for 7 years, for a month around Christmas time. And the church in Oberndorf, which I went to, had an organist. In the 70s, there was no heat. And the organ, the person who played the organ, the organist, we were renting from him. And so we would sit up in the choir loft and listen to him, watch him play. He had a heavy coat on with big thick gloves playing the organ. And this breath was just spewing out because it was so cold. So when you think you have it hard in the churches here with nice warm heat, you remember Oberndorf in the 70s, they had no heat, and I guess they do now. Anyway, what we're going to do, I'd like to ask Phyllis Carlin to come up. Phyllis Carlin is a member of our community. Many of you know her. She has done many performances on this stage, playing that piano for the variety show. She plays for the chorale when we need someone to play. And she plays in her own church, which is Creekwood, I understand. And she's a very fine pianist. We're going to sing four songs. The music, yes, give Phyllis a hand. We're going to sing four. One will be, the first one will be Silent Night. The second one, O Come All Ye Faithful. The third one, Joy to the World. And the fourth one will be, We Wish You a Merry Christmas. The first three, we will go right in. Phyllis will play a little interlude, bringing us into the next one. Now, I'm going to start you, but I'm not singing it for you. You're singing it for all your friends and neighbors, so I want to hear a big noise coming from out here. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh, just a minute, Santa. Let me tell them something. I just wanted to say something. Joy to the world. This is a little trivia. A little trivia. To show you how the world changes. And let's hope that it changes back again. Quite a few years ago, I had the good fortune of living in Iran for 6 years. And we sang Joy to the World in the churches there. There was a Protestant church and a Catholic church, and we all celebrated Christmas, and it was wide open, and you know, the Iranians sent so many beautiful Christmas cards to us. They may not have known why it was so important to us, but they supported us. And we sang Joy to the World in Farsi. I'll never forget that. I wish that day would return. Anyway, now you're on, Santa.
Folks, we're going to try something tonight, so please join Santa. We're going to try to do a little quick video that we can share in a few days with those that are part of our club that weren't able to join us tonight. So will you join us in singing along here, please? And if you're posing the thing on camera, a duck.
John Lennon would say if he was here tonight. So he would be very appreciative. And you ought to stand where I'm standing and look at all those candles out there. Thank God we managed to keep them under control, so good for you. All right, so listen, we're coming up to the end of our meeting. Please remember at the end of this meeting, we will have people posted at both doors. Please turn your name badges in. We have to get them all to get scheduled for next month. Now, next month, we swing back into the political realm because early, the first week in March, are the elections. And so we will be presenting several forms throughout January and February so that you get a chance to see all the important candidates in all of the important races together. So we'll have that here for you. The first session will be January the 10th, and we'll have the representative from the U.S. Congress. That will be Suzanne Hart, Keith Self, and Van Taylor. So those three people will be here that night, and you'll get a chance to see them in action and help make your decision about who you should vote for. After that, we will have the Justice Texas Supreme Court, place number 9, and the two candidates there are David Schnett and Evan Young. After that, that will conclude that January 10th meeting. That is a dinner meeting. The meeting on January the 24th is not a dinner meeting, it's an open meeting. We figure you can only handle one of these dinners a month. So we'll have the January 24th meeting, and we'll have all that information for you when we finish the January 10th meeting. Or our marketing team will blast that out to you on our new website. So in closing, we want to, once again, the Republican Club of Heritage Ranch, the board of directors, myself, all of our members are wishing you and all of your families the most blessed and merriest of Christmas ever. So thank you, God bless you all. We appreciate you dearly. Good night.